And I need you now tonight. Man, I need you more than ever. And if you only hold me tight, we'll be holding on forever. And we'll only be making it right, 'cause we'll never be wrong together. We can make it till the end of the night. The love is like a shadow on me all of the time.
All of the time.
I don't know what to do. I'm always in the dark. I'm even in a powder keg and giving off sparks. Giving I really need sparks. You tonight. Forever's gonna start tonight. Forever's gonna start tonight. Yeah, we'll end it there. Hello, people. I'm sorry, I can't remember all the lyrics.
Yeah, we should probably actually practice.
Yeah, this is WhiteWing and WolfsSOL here doing another Dark Souls Let Play commentary, this time in the depths.
Yes. I actually did the depths. How to put this? This is still lower on Dead Berg at this point.
Yep.
I did this bit twice. I think I cut out the second one.
That reminds me. We've been calling Lower on Dead Break the depths for like the last two videos.
I know. But we consider it the depths because we tend to do them at the same time.
Yeah.
Like you go down, kill Capra, go further down, do the depths, and you're done.
Yeah, you get it over and done with. Like ripping off a band-aid.
But yeah, as you can see, I only have the two Estus left over.
Or waxing your ass.
Ha! Got him! See, timing is very important when you're using a heavy weapon such as this one. Learning the timings on your attacks really, really helps. Badness.
Yeah, that really helped there.
So yeah, because I have so few Estus, I decide to pretty much just go grab the large ember, then go buff my axe a little bit and come back. I did cut out the majority of that.
Understandable.
Yeah, it's basically just pointless busy work running from one area to the next.
And so, we've already had the discussion about cuts last episode.
Yes, we did. Can't believe I'm having so much trouble with these goddamn... Yes! That was lucky. If he hadn't charged me at that moment, I would not have gotten the kill there.
Mm. Alright. Butchers. We've discussed these people before.
Yeah, we don't have to... He broke the table! Bastard! This butcher doesn't aggro until you break the table. Well, it does, but
it gets a little worse if you break the table. Well, not really. It
definitely aggroes when you break the table.
Yeah.
But, you know, a fairly easy fight. Lots of janky slowdown. Ugh. Really getting tired of these frame rate issues.
Django?
Janky, oh. I said. Really getting tired of these frame rate issues. As you can see, I'm out of Estus, so I figure, fuck it. We'll just stop that there. I had originally planned to have that on the tail end of the last episode, but it was running way over time. Alright, so here we are back again. I've switched to human form because I want to be human as much as possible. Because my character is sexier that way.
And he knows it?
He does know it. Look at him. Look at him with that sexy ass haircut. Frame rate, why are you so piss me off?
Because it doesn't like you.
Yeah, so I won't be going to pick up the spider shield because I already have one.
I don't like you either.
Now I would like you to see the damage on this plunging attack right here.
You should be careful. I have a bounty in and 5 systems.
Leap and plunge for 1500 damage in a single hit. And the rat keels over in shock.
I think he's had a run-in with a bandit before. I mean, there's the shield upstairs, and he has a battle axe sticking out of one of his eyes.
He sure does, but my axe is a little bit bigger.
It is a bit bigger.
Alright, almost ran past the key.
don't run past that key. It's a nice key.
Yep. Just I figure I'll try and just manage to catch one of the rats there.
Slide.
Very important to stay on the left.
Just bounce.
Seriously,
just slide,
to stay on the left-hand side of that as you're sliding down.
Yeah.
Because if you're anywhere else, you fall down into, oh my god, I've been cursed and turned into a statue territory.
I like last time I ran through, though, there were like 7 little statue things.
Yeah. I'll have to go down there someday and actually show people what it looks like.
Mm. Wait, you don't go down there?
No, I never go down.
You don't get the Ring of Evil Eye and farm it for,
What, Eyes of Death?
Yeah.
What do you think I am, a Gravelord, Gravekeeper? I'm not a Gravekeeper. This isn't New Game Plus. Why would I want Eyes of Death?
You're no fun.
Seriously, that really pissed me off when I heard about that. The fact that, what is it? Gravelord Servants? Yeah, Gravelord Servants.
Yep.
Just don't work in the normal game. They only work in New Game Plus.
After all the effort you put into doing that.
I became a Gravekeeper at, like, level 3 once, just so I could abuse it in... the Undead Parish. But it didn't work! I had a character like there with the, using the Eye of Death for a long time.
What's with the speed up?
The speed up is because I had to go kill the channeler and the giant rats, and I killed these guys. And the episode was about 18 minutes long, and YouTube doesn't let me upload those anymore.
Do you get any shards from these, or are you unlucky?
Unlucky. I have 10 humanity, so chances are I should have gotten one or two, but nothing.
Hell, even I don't farm those guys anymore. I farm the slugs down in Blighttown.
Yeah, the slugs have a higher drop rate in general. They're not so good for large shards, though.
I get a nice, decent supply of them.
So I got the Great Axe there.
Yeah,
it's shittier
not
than
that
the
great.
Demon Great Axe, but it has a very similar moveset. The only difference is that it's R2. This two-handed R2 doesn't do the same, wind-up hit.
I don't know. If I was going to use the Great Axe for anything, I'd probably use it for making the Golem Axe.
Yeah, probably. Golem Axe is a lot better than the Great Axe.
That or I wouldn't waste the Great Axe and I'd just do it with a Battle Axe. You can pick up heaps of those.
I remember the first time I came here with a Demon Great Axe like this. I jumped over the stairs and plunging attacked the channeler.
And then the rats ate you, didn't they?
And then the rats ate me. It was hilarious, but... yeah, the rats, as you can see, not much of a challenge.
I really wish, just off one of these two channelers, I know it's rare, but I wish I'd pick up that bloody trident.
The trident is hilarious because it has a special ability. You know the dance that they do that buffs enemies around them?
You can do it!
If you have the trident and you're holding it in both hands, I believe, and you use the R2, you dance. It's like, dance, baby! And it buffs you. You do more damage with that buff active.
I know. There's, on the Dark Soul wiki, for the crossbow that you pick up in the Duke's Archives, there's a video, and it begins with showing some bloke killing a channeler. It's like, oh, the trident. One of the things I wanted. Now I can do what I've been wanting to do all game. Dance, bitches! And he starts dancing. She's like, oh yeah, oh yeah.
Fun times. Fun
thing
times.
Thing is, it buffs you a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. I already mentioned that.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Alright, so we're back to normal speed here because we're just about ready to take on the Gaping Dragon.
You don't kill, Kirk?
No.
You'll never be able to fight him again, you know.
Yeah,
not here.
I know.
Why don't you kill Kirk?
I don't care about Kirk.
He deserves it.
Look, if I were going to fight Kirk, I would have to go down into cursed frog territory.
No, you don't.
Yes, I would.
You don't. You go in like the first 5 meters of it where there are no cursed frogs.
I care not for your...
logic.
Blah, 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 blah.
My actual good argument here that point makes a fine point.
Allow me to put it this way. I don't want his armor. I don't want his weapons. I don't need his humanity. And he gives very, very few souls. Why would I do it?
You don't want to look like you just walked out of an S&M club?
I would just equip Havel's shield and use its R2 ability.
That would make you look like you were in an S&M club.
You don't know about Havel's special ability?
I've never really used the Havel shield.
You know the Iron Flesh pyromancy spell?
I'm familiar with that useless piece of shit, yes.
Havel's shield, if you use the parry button with it, will buff you with iron flesh. But instead of turning you into iron, you sprout thorns. It's actually really good. So the Gaping Dragon trolls me a little bit here, and basically just chases me around the room for like a minute and a half until my buff wears off.
Yeah, he'll
because
do
Gaping
that.
Dragon is a douchebag.
It could be worse.
And I do the right thing too. I don't just run away the whole time. I like turn back, make sure I'm in prime stamp down territory. He just refuses to do the move.
Could be worse.
Yeah, it could be worse. I could be having horrible frame rate troubles here and be on like 15 frames per second.
No, you could have summoned your two little summons up there. You know,
and have just made Gaping Dragon stronger for no reason.
Yep.
And they could be getting their asses handed to them by him.
Yeah.
Seriously, there is no NPC summon in the game that can fight Gaping Dragon without being a complete retard.
Oh yeah, you summon both of them and they'll just stand in front and then they'll get eaten and then they'll die and then you're left with a Gaping Dragon whose health is like...
Hey, look at that! He didn't even do the charge!
Yeah, that's because there was no even chance of it hitting you. He will completely just not do it if he can't get a slight shot at you.
And... shablam! I maintain that should have hit.
You've got horrible aim.
Screw you. It takes time to adapt to a new to a different weapon. All right, fuck you. And look at the ridiculous amounts of damage this thing does. This isn't even upgraded very much, and I have low strength.
Mm. You're giving him a good, you know, nice ass pounding there.
Damn straight, bro. I give the best ass poundings.
Why is it always the gay jokes with us?
Because I like the gay jokes.
I know.
And because I am the gay. I have a case of the gay.
You know, I don't think they've been calling it that since the 70s.
That just makes it funnier to say. Now, at this point, I know that before he can get an attack off, I can get one more. So, bam, fight over. Fuck you, Gaping Dragon.
Hell, you might as well be making blaxploitation movies while you're at it.
People are still making those. They're funny.
I know, they are funny. These days are funny.
If you have an opportunity to check out a movie called Black Dynamite, for the love of God, watch a movie called Black Dynamite. It is the funniest fucking piece of shit. It is a spoof of a... It's a spoof of, like, all blaxploitation movies ever made.
Hmm.
Made in, what was it, like 2007, 2008? It was
I can't remember.
And it is hilarious. It's one of my favorite movies of all time. It's got like everything. Like the shitty dialogue, the fucked up, useless martial arts crap, the pointless violence, the black dude teaching a martial arts class in his living room, the boom mics that kind of like dip into frame, and the actor distracted by it, like trying to signal the mic guy, and it's like, get it out of the frame, come on. And it's like, that's the scene that I remember most strongly from it, is that thing of him on the phone with the boom mic, like in front of his afro, and just like winking at the mic guy to try and get it out of the way. And
oh, it could have been worse. They could have decided to poke, instead of just going for like insulting the 70s blaxploitation movies, they could have also, you know, done the let's insult Christian Bale while we're at it and just had him like drop the phone and start yelling at the boom mic guy.
Well, there was that other scene where it's like they're doing a fight scene and he slaps a guy like by accident. He slaps a stunt guy and the stunt guy goes, "You mother," and it does a hard cut, and all of a sudden the stunt guy is a different stunt guy. Good times. So because I don't have the master key, I can't do my preferred method of doing Blighttown, so for the very first time in my Dark Souls career, I'm going to have to do the real Blighttown.
Oh, it's not too bad.
True. I do die like 3 times, but they're all in the same area. Once I figured out that area, I went through no problem.
Which area?
I got the Ito.
Yep.
I got to the bonfire.
Yep.
And then I died 3 times.
The
first little area just after there.
The two dogs and the
two, clearing the two dogs, then getting a little bit further, and a blow dart guy.
Oh, answer to that's very simple.
Over where the eagle shield is.
Yeah, very simple answer
to
that.
Yeah, I know, alright, I know. I get through it in the end. Alright, so that's all the time we have for today. We shall see you all tomorrow with some Blighttown. Lovely.
It's nice been talking and serenading you.
It's nice done been talking and serenading you.
We started with a song.
Well, yeah. Should we start with a song tomorrow?
Maybe. We'll have to think a song that we actually remember the goddamn lyrics to and don't have to try and pull out the top of your head while in the middle of singing.
You mean Bohemian Rhapsody, of course.
Yeah, why not?
Alright, guys. Return tomorrow for some lovely Queen from a Queen and his friend.
Ew.
And, yeah. Have fun. Enjoy. Goodbye!
See ya.